Welcome back to Let's Play Ambermoon Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're about to head into the graveyard? Cemetery? Something like that. There's obviously going to be undead there. I think they call it a graveyard. You need to get a brooch from the graveyard to get the Thieves Guild password. You have to give the brooch back to Amon. I guess he's probably in the Thieves Guild. Oh, cemetery, actually. Okay. Let's hope we don't die horribly. Ooh. Spooky noises. On the base of the statue, you can read, "Bela, goddess of death, may you guard the peace of the dead forever." Apparently, some strange runes were added to this recently. Oh boy. So we have things we can... Let's see our runes here. Okay. The runes. Read... Loving the music, not though. Not for M-U-C. Not for much L. Not for much longer? G-E-R. Not for much longer. You think I know this. Like by heart by now. Is that an A or C? What's an S? Okay, not for much longer. As I am. No. Yeah. Not for much longer as I am... What's that even supposed to mean, though? I'm waiting for it to make a little bit of sense. It's not. As I am... Crap. I should do this off-screen like I used to. As I am... The... As I am the God? As I am the God of Death, I'm guessing D H T H. As I am the God of Death. Not for much longer as I am the God of Death. And then what's this say? G go seems like an arrow. Gordon? It's a Y kinda. Yeah, Gordon. Okay, I'll just put this over here. I see then. Can't read. We can go through there, huh? A freshly dug grave lies before you. Who will it be to hopefully find peace here? I have no idea. In any case, nothing of interest. And I left. I did not mean to leave. Okay. Haha, just trying to turn around. Suddenly the ground beside you is torn apart and the hand of an undead reaches for the ankle of Citrine. With grotesque howling, more of those that escape from Bela's realm break out of the moist ground and attack you. Okay. Ooh. We got here. Undead knights. Oh, that's our... Oh, I didn't want it to be like that. Ooh, short bow. Not good. So they're zombies, not death knights. Oh, they shoot with arrows now. Party advances. Oh, we move forward. Okay, that's what that does. Hey. Hopefully he's equipped with... Yeah. And I will move over to assist. Is his short bow broken? Zombies, awesome. Take him downtown. Failed, 4 points. He's punching now, I guess. I did a point. Three points of damage on me. Zombie did two. Agile did point damage finally. At least I didn't see him do any before. Okay, I'm like pretty damaged. Healing potion two. Healing potion one. I want to use these up. I don't have a lot of them. Probably gonna have to, though. Okay, we all failed that time. It went by so quick. What did it say? He's out of ammunition or something? Or was reloading? Zombie dropped a weapon. Great, now I'm gonna be attacked by two of them. Can we just take this one out? I think I was already was being attacked by two of them. Well, actually, there should be one on me. Oh boy. Is this too hard for us? I think this only gives us back 1 point, though. Actually, I'm gonna use the healing potion too. on Agile. And Agile will continue to attack, and hopefully... it didn't work. The attack, rather. So he is... a little better. Okay, this is tough. Oh, no spells. Does Edgil know spells? I doubt it. He's a knight-type character, no. Oh, I'm not attack- duh. That doesn't help. Points. Come on, kill it. Ah, nice. So I want to do... okay. So I'm going to move over, so it moves over. I'm going to have him... here. I'm gonna wait for it to move over. I think it dropped its weapon. Okay. So actually, I think technically we can both now attack it. Because I'm standing next to it, which I'm not used to. I'm still not used to Amber Star. You cannot stand next to enemies like that. I get 2 against 1. Maybe we'll level up from this. These are tough enemies. 40 experience points. Okay, so we can take this stuff to sell. Padded leather? Oh. Arrow, short sword. 60 gold spread among us. Let's see if we're getting to right click it. So they were attacking us with swords after that. So that's the way out. Wait a second. Does that say anything? So I can just fast travel back to the tavern. Yeah, the music doesn't stop. Okay. I will... yeah, we will rest. And then... what do we talk to about a room? I don't remember. Ah. We could probably rest outside, but we might get attacked by stuff. And you can't just sleep on the city streets, I'm pretty sure. So, yeah, yes. Thank you. I want to know spells, damn you. That's not that kind of scroll. We're just resting. Yay. Alright, good. We have to go out here. Sidle out of the way, old man. I'm gonna sell some equipment. Now, the merchant, I think we could not sell any more to him because his slots were filled. The door is locked. It almost seems as if the shop is closed at the moment. My God. Well, I guess it is. Wait, oh. I said we slept until dawn. Can we go in now? Yes. His slots are filled. But technically we can sell him short swords because they stack. Oh, sadly I cannot buy any more. You know, before I forgot to look at this padded leather. See, I'm wearing just regular leather. That's shield plus 5. Padded leather. Shield plus 6. Okay. So give me that. And then my shield go up to 10. Okay. And we have 240 gold. Well, I have 240 gold and he has 240 gold. So 480. Math. Yay. So is there anything we'd like? I'm not even sure what those do. Well, do I have something about that? No. I just want this. I don't know what the. Yeah, I don't know what those do, so I'm gonna not buy them yet. I mean, technically I can't afford them, but... Ironclad leather. Maybe we don't have enough. Well, it gives us a total gold here anyway, 480. Sandals, leather shoes, leather boots for 200. That would free up a slot as well. He might just have no more gold left, because that's... I sold him that for 1,000? Oh. We got rocks and sling stones. A rune table. For 50, I mean... What a ripoff. Chainmail shirt we cannot afford. But let's see. Do any of us need boots? Yeah, I'm wearing leather shoes, and he's wearing sandals. Sandals are shield plus 1. Boots are shield plus 2. Or rather, those aren't boots. Those are leather shoes, sorry. I'm focused on the boots right now. The leather boots we can afford, and the shield plus 4. I will buy one of those. I'll take them. And then leather shoes, I guess. $250 for a short sword. I think that's what he's using, a short sword, right? A long sword. I am also using a long sword. So I don't think there's anything else we can buy at this moment. Unless we want more torches, which we probably do need more torches. We have 2. Yeah, we only have 2. So let me buy a few torches then. 10 gold pieces just for 10? Well, then I'm gonna buy like 20 of them. Let's keep it reasonable. Torches are cheap. I like torches. Alright, so... Oh wait, I gotta get in the habit of this. Boop! Boop. Now, if I can sell him some things, that'd be very helpful. Okay, plain leather, yes. Oh, he doesn't sell potions, does he? I didn't see them there. Wait, no. I was like, when do we get a chainmail shirt? You know, maybe hold on to that in case ours breaks. Now I'm gonna keep one dagger and one short sword in case they break. You know, our current weapons. The robe. The robe is... Shield plus four. Nowhere near as good as the leather, you know. More short swords. Okay, you know what? Sell the dagger. And sell one other short sword. And keep a padded leather in case one of our leathers breaks. Well, not a padded leather, but you know what I mean. Actually, that's the one we haven't put on yet, right? We already have padded leather. Okay, we have extra. Okay. And I want to keep the short bow and arrow just in case. How are we with weight? He's good. I'm not too good. Oh, you know what? Here. Boots. Shield going from 10 to 12. That'll probably help. And then he'll take my leather shoes. Shield, yeah, shield going from 8 to 9. Unfortunately, that guy only had one pair of boots. My incredible bargains. Alright, sell the sandals. Padded leather, boom. Okay, leather shoes, sandals, chainmail, cannot get. We have that. Cannot afford. Actually, technically, we can afford that now. Ironclad leather? Wow. Wind pearl. Does Edgel need a buckler or something like that? I have a buckler. He has a buckler. Alright. So let's take a look at the ironclad leather. Never heard of such a thing, ironclad leather. The armor on that is plus 7 versus our own plus 6. Hmm, I think I'll get it though. I'm gonna give it to whoever has the least hit points, which I think is me. 33. Oh no, it's Edgel. Okay. I think Edgel has to catch up. I'm an adventurer 5, he's a warrior 1. Now, I know the magic classes in this game are different than Amber or Star. You can be an alchemist, you can be various things. I haven't decided where I'm going yet with it. But you can keep leveling up as adventurer for a while, at least. Okay, so we're gonna give him the ironclad leather, then. And then watch his armor class go from 9 to 10. And I am 12. Oh, it's still got it better. Is it because I have the boots? Probably because I have the boots. Maybe I should give him the boots. Because I have more hit points. And we have... we have a padded leather. And we have another padded leather. So I'm going to sell one padded leather. I mean, what if both break, right? But... I do want to keep our weight down so we can collect goodies and come back here and sell them. So I want item into money. And I'm going to sell one padded leather back. Kind of a waste that we did it that way, but... because you lose money by selling back than if you had never bought it in the first place. So 259 gold. That's pretty good. Alright, so we don't have to have to stumble all the way over there. And just go like that. Go like that. And then I can save. Unlucky number 13. No, I don't want to quit. Back into the fray. I'm guessing there's nothing really around here. We have to go through here. Did I look at this grave? I don't know if they say anything. The older part of the graveyard seems to start here. Through an opening in the hedge, you see mists wafting over the graves, and your hair stands on end. I love the flavor text. You summon all your courage and step cautiously through the hedge. You look around and suddenly see the glowing red eye sockets of skeletons and zombies. They clamber out of an open grave to the southeast and stagger towards you. Behind the jerking masses of bone and foul flesh, you feel you can make out the figure of an old man in a rotting cloak. It seems as if he is directing the undead. Oh, I have a feeling we're not going to survive this. Oh, hello. Sure. Okay. Okay, you said zombies and skeletons. We have... I forgot to change our roster, our zombie master. Yeah, I don't think... he's probably gonna throw spells at us. Oh, we're probably dead. I forgot to change our lineup here. I kinda wanna stick together here. The irritate spell. I don't know if it worked. Does anyone have irritate? Anyone feel irritated right now? No. I guess it didn't work. Probably dodged it by moving. Alright. So far, so good. Oh, what was that? Oh, he's throwing rocks at us. I love the animations. Awesome. 1 point of damage. Is that all that happened? I got hit by more than that, yeah. I'm down 6 points. 1 point of damage. What happened? That was his thing broken, right? Zombie did 6. Ouch. Skeleton did 5? Whoa. I only have one of these left. Yeah, I don't think we're gonna survive this fight. Skeleton is 6. Magical projectile spell. Oh my god. Oh! You're the leader! You're doomed! Yeah, we're gonna go do something else. It's only through sheer morbid curiosity that I'm use his last ammunition that I'm continuing with this. I just want to see if he can take out the one zombie, or skeleton rather. That's a skeleton. I wonder what's tougher, a skeleton or a zombie. But I don't think he can because he's not hitting. He's a beginning fighter here. We need more people. Higher levels. And maybe better armor and weapons. But at least we did achieve some stuff this episode. We did defeat those 2 zombies. And we got a bunch of new equipment. Things are looking good. I think we might go after the bandits instead. So I'm not sure where they are. I have to consult my notes. No one's hitting. This probably gets at least slightly better in the, as we get up levels. But in the other case, they hit us more as well. So I guess maybe I should have kept my armor class up. It's just he has the least hit points. Yet he technically lasted longer, but they were going after me. Tullamar the house dealer has the pickaxe. Tools for chest. Return the golden horseshoes from Silverhand, who is the leader of the bandits. Silverhand, leader of the bandits, headquarters, middle of the desert, north of town. So we're going into the desert, north of town, guys, next episode. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time, and always, seek adventure.